Welcome to 2022-2023 Grayson County High School Meet the Cougar Night as Grayson County's Lady Cougars and Cougars introduce themselves to you, and we will help in that process as well. And a good evening and welcome into the Cougar Den for the first time for basketball season here in 2022. Sam Gormley with you for another edition and the kickoff, or tip-off, I should say, of another season of Cougar basketball right here on K105 Digital Productions. We have a great night planned for you today, and to kind of go over a little bit of what you're going to be seeing with us this evening. Of course, we're going to be introducing you to both of these teams as Grayson County Cougars, the district champions last year. The Lady Cougars, rebuilding year, but they're trying to build upon that and see what they can't do this season. We'll introduce you to both of them. We'll talk to head coach Todd Johnston of the Lady Cougars, assistant coach Brett Johnston of the Cougar Boys. We might talk to some players. There's going to be an alumni three-point contest today, as I've even got the matchups sitting in front of me. Here is the alumni that you're going to be see shooting: Allie Horton, Phoebe Goldsmith, Alex Majors, Haley Smith, Kelsey Martin, Chelsea Gilbert is the Lady Cougars version, and the Cougar Boys, Trey Goff, Alex Schellhart, Ethan Sulzman, Mason Galloway, Bryce Meredith, and Keegan Sharp. So Keegan Sharp, he's warming up in the best way that you possibly can have. Is down. He's sitting in front of our vantage point right now. He's got a dog with him. I mean, listen, he's got a lucky dog, and he is ready to roll as he's going to be going up against River Blanton. Oop, I'm not sure if I was supposed to say that matchup just quite yet, but it should be a lot of fun here today as these two teams are going to introduce themselves. But it's not just that. We might see some introductions of cheerleaders, as well as the junior pro and middle school basketball players are going to be introduced throughout this evening's game. This Grayson County Lady Cougar team last year, only 3 wins, but if you watch them last season from game one when they played Breckenridge County here at the Cougar Den almost a year ago to the final game at Butler County, they improved drastically. It was obvious as they got so much better, and it was a lot of fun watching them improve. The Cougar Boys on the other side, some ups and downs throughout the year, but had the up of winning the district tournament. In fact, coming as the 4 seed in the district tournament and upsetting Butler County and then winning the district championship, just winning it on a last-second buzzer beater. I mean, I'm not sure that you can draw up winning a district championship any better than winning on the buzzer beater by Hunter Toms. Cougars fell then in the 3rd region tournament to Hancock County, as that game was one that the Cougars just – the shots weren't falling, and Hancock was able to pull away and pick up the win there in the 3rd region quarterfinals. Tomorrow, if you're still looking for an opportunity to see the Cougar Boys in action, they're going to be hosting a full day of scrimmages here at the Cougar Den. As, in fact, at the first matchup of the day is going to be Whitesville Trinity against Atherton, a school out of Louisville. That'll be at 11 a.m. 1 o'clock, it'll be Ohio County against Metcalf County. That'll be an opportunity there to see a 3rd region team as well. 3 o'clock, it'll be Breck County against Monroe County. 5 o'clock will be Davis County against Greenwood. And then 7 o'clock will be your Cougars as they will take on Hart County. All of those games are going to be tomorrow at the Cougar Den. So if you're looking for something to do, maybe you're a UK football fan like myself and not really wanting to watch the Cats tomorrow because it might get a little ugly when they play Georgia. Maybe looking for something to do. It's going to be a chilly day. It'll be perfect to come out. And also the most important thing is that this is a fundraiser for the Cougar Boys. So it's good to come out and support this team. And they're playing a Hart County team tomorrow night that's really solid from the 5th region. And I'm really excited to see what they'll come up with. And tomorrow, and it'll be your first opportunity to see the Cougar Boys in action. When you look at both of their schedules for the year, first off, for the Lady Cougars, they will open the season coming up on November the 29th as they will be at Breckenridge County. Their first home game then will be on the Saturday, December the 3rd, will be against University Heights when they'll play. But before that, they'll also hit the road and go north. They'll play Bullitt Central on that Friday of the 1st week, and then they'll return home again on the Tuesday as we get a district doubleheader, or not district doubleheader, but the first doubleheader of the season at home will be against Ohio County. That'll come up on December the 6th. And then, let's just open it up. How do you open it up much better than that? In fact, we're going to turn it over now to public address announcer Brian Payton for your introductions today.
Grayson County High School. Got a couple quick announcements. announcements. Make sure you all visit the concession stand tonight. Also, our silent auction items are located by the gym doors. It is a signed boys high school basketball and girls signed basketball. At this time, before we get started with the other festivities, I'd like to ask everyone to please stand for the playing of our national anthem.
During the national anthem, we'll take a quick break because this is the Meet the Cougar Night on K105.
When caring for a family member, their state of health is continually on your mind. And when they're faced with a health concern, you'll do just about anything to make them feel better. Rest assured, their feel better starts right here at Midway Pharmacy. We take our time to get to know all about your family's health history so we can provide you with educated advice. So when someone's counting on you to help them maintain a healthy lifestyle or to overcome that untimely sickness, remember, Midway Pharmacy.
Connection. It's the name of the game in Grayson County schools. Connection with students, with colleagues, with community, through relationships, through partnerships, through small daily acts, through high impact programs at all levels. Connections that teach, that encourage, that build confidence, that show together we can, preparing students for life equipped with real and real world skills for success. Together, we are GC Connected.
Hi, can I help you?
I just wanted to say thank you. Bye.
Can I help you?
Yeah, just wanted to say thanks.
For what?
For all the money that's been flying out of your drafty windows and doors this winter. It's just so generous of you. So, we wanted to say thanks.
We?
Yeah, the whole neighborhood's here.
Thank you. Stop throwing your money out the window. Visit us at Future Designs Building Materials on Quarry Road in Litchfield.
We know windows and doors.
The builder's choice.
Oh boy.
What?
We better get out of here. That clown is about to hit a water line.
He didn't contact 811 to mark the underground utilities.
Nope.
You saw that coming. Too bad he didn't.
Know what's below. 811 before you did.
They just wrapped up the national anthem, so we'll get ready to head back to public address announcer Brian Payton again for your introductions of this year's Grayson County Cougars.
The high school cheerleaders to do a performance tonight. However, most of them are out with the flu, so that will not be taking place. But we do like to dedicate tonight to Mr. E.E. McGee.
Drawing.
Grayson County High School's Meet the Cougar Night with you. Sam Gormley here is coming up here in just a few moments. Later when the teams scrimmage, we're going to talk to some of the coaches and help you get a better understanding of what this year's team is. So we'll talk to Brett Johnston, assistant coach. It looks like they're going to announce the junior pros. So we'll jump in and do this.
Again, all junior pro middle school basketball players are in attendance. Please come down to the gym floor.
Sean, that's not you. Sit down. We always running.
So right now they're introducing the junior pro and middle school basketball players. I know both middle school teams have had great starts to the year. The seventh grade boys, I know, are still undefeated. As they're announcing them, I don't know that they're...
Ladies and gentlemen, let's give these boys a round of applause.
Just going to give them their share and their moments. This is the future of Grayson County High School basketball. Taking the floor right there. They're going to clear it off. But we are going to talk to both head coaches, or the head coach at least of the Lady Cougars, Todd Johnston, and we'll talk to the assistant coach, Brett Johnston, later on once they start. So we mentioned, we were talking before we went to break, is the Lady Cougar basketball schedule. We'll go to the Cougar boys now, as they also will open up the season at Breckenridge County. But then they will come home on that Thursday, December the 1st, as they will host Bullet Central. And then on the Saturday, they are going to go on the road as they will play at Campbellsville, as that will start at 7 o'clock. We won't have a broadcast of that game because we'll be with the Lady Cougars as they'll host University Heights that day. But those are some of the games that you have to look forward to. Some holiday tournaments as well, including that the Cougar boys are going to be hosting their own holiday tournament this season. We'll have more on that just a little bit later on in the broadcast. In fact, we're even going to give you one of the first looks at this year's bracket for the Grayson County basketball bracket for the holiday tournament that will be hosted after Christmas. We'll show you that here in just a few moments. Again, we're not going to we'll leave that for a tease later on in the broadcast. It'll be the first look at that. And again, as a reminder, there's scrimmages all day tomorrow here for you to be able to come out and support this Grayson County basketball team. And it's your first chance to see them in person, as the Cougar boys last week on Saturday played at Taylor County in a scrimmage. High-scoring game, fell, but again, it's a little bit... Let's see, looks like they're going to introduce the Cougars now.
Lady Cougar and Cougar basketball team. School players, Bree Jones, Kaden Henshaw, Jordan Perkins, Jack Roxton, Peyton Bowman, Spencer Langdon, Anna Smith, Kyle Hickman, and Addison Spainhauer. And now introducing our freshman class, Haley Miller, Gage Napier, Lucy Torrance, Chase Bunnock, Kennedy Green, Jake Bratcher, Lexi Logston, Brody Armstrong, and Bryson Lambert. Over to our sophomore class, Brooklyn Dennis, Kobe Martin, Ellen Arvaez, Zach Bratcher, Isabel Blanton, Landon Haycraft, Sutton Van Meer, Hayden Robinson, and Jaden Pierce.
Oh, she on there too? I'll go ahead and have her manager.
On the sophomore list for girls is Abigail Pennington.
They didn't have that down.
Sydney Perkins. Mason Carroll. Nino Iardia. And finally, over to our seniors, Brightley Renfro, River Blanton, Arissa Riggs, Dylan Horn, Camden Brothers, Lucas Pierce, Braden Childress, and Bentley Martin. Our managers, Abigail Pennington, Cole Snyder, Ryan Keyes, Eddie Yarborough, Jared Henson, Eddie Mudd, Carly Cook, and Shelby Sanders. The Lady Cougar coaching staff, head coach Todd Johnston, Elena Jones, and Brian Jones. And your boys' coaching staff, head coach Travis Johnston, Brett Johnston, Daryl Meredith, Brian Hill, and Mike McClintock. Ladies and gentlemen, these are your 2022-2023 Lady Cougar and Cougar basketball team.
That's beating the Cougars. 2022-23 Grayson County Cougars and Lady Cougars. We get close now to jumping into the alumni contest. And this will be three-point shooting contest.
And next on tonight's agenda is the girls' three-point shootout sponsored by Mr. Gaines.
It'll be the three-point shooting contest. You'll have Allie Horton, Phoebe Goldsmith,
Alex Majors, Haley Smith, Kelsey Martin, and Chelsea Gilbert.
We're going to let the players warm up a little bit while we get ready to roll. As again, your matchups. It's going to be Allie Horton against Lucy Torrance, Phoebe Goldsmith against Arissa Riggs, Alex Majors against Isabel Blanton, Haley Smith against Briley Napier, or Briley Renfro, rather. I can't believe I've never made that mistake. It's Briley Napier worked on our crew for a while, but it's Briley Renfro. I don't think Briley Napier is going to be coming out here shooting. So Haley Smith against Briley Renfro, Kelsey Martin against Ella Narvaez, and Chelsea Gilbert against Sutton Van Meter. The Cougar boys matchup will be Trey Goff against Dylan Horn, Alex Schillhart against Camden Brothers, Ethan Sulzman against Lucas Pierce, Mason Galloway versus Braden Childress, Dr. Bryce Meredith against Bentley Martin, and Keegan Sharp against River Blanton. And that right there is the matchup that I have circled, because Keegan Sharp is the all-time three-point leader in Grayson County High School boys basketball history. So you got to be ready for when Keegan can let it fly. And I also like, you know, the Lady Cougars right now, they're out there warming up, getting loose. Alumni, they don't even need it. They're too big. I mean, they don't even need to go out there and shoot a little bit. They're ready to roll right away. I respect it. I like it. Why even warm up? I just hope Trainer Scott's got some extra ice ready, because I don't know. I mean, I know if I'd get out there, I'd need it by the end of it. We'll try to see if they are ready to roll. I'm not sure how long of a warm-up as they're going to be having. So look here, head coach Travis Johnston for the boys, not here today, has a good reason. We'll talk about that in a little bit. He just leaves us a comment on Facebook as he makes up big-time shooters for the boys' side. You got Keegan Sharp, most threes in three-point history. Again, we should mention that second place is Travis Johnston. Keegan passed him last season. And Trey Goff holds the record for most three-point makes in a season. So you got some shooters. Is Trey Goff going to go up against Dylan Horn? Keegan Sharp going to go up against River Blanton. So the girls are still warming up right now on the floor as they get ready to come out and let it shoot and let it roll.
Thank you.
see how close they come. But again, this Lady Cougar and Cougar basketball team both will open up the year on November the 29th as they will travel to Breckenridge County. That'll be a good early test for both of these programs. Breckenridge County, I mean, it's one of those, it's similar to an Edmondson County where you can throw a lot of those rivalries. I mean, it's a rivalry, so everybody, there come the alumni, they're going to get loose a little bit. I was a little worried they weren't going to get out there and shoot a little bit, just get loose and get warmed up and see what they can't do. And I'm excited to see what some of these matchups might have. But that'll be a good early test for both of these teams. And we do want to invite you, too, to stay on the lookout, a little preview of what's to come next week. We're going to have the first ever third region media poll that will be released hopefully next week, if not the week after. We have 13 media representatives from across the region representing 13 of the 15 third region schools that have all put in polls. We're still waiting on a couple to send in. But it's very interesting seeing what the media has a feel on who will be and what they think about each of these teams and also what they think about the 12th District as a whole. It's interesting. Right now, one team has received all of the first-place votes in boys, and one team has received all but one of the first-place votes in girls. So it's interesting to see there. But then after that, it gets very interesting. I mean, we've seen some teams on some ballots ranked as high as third and then not even ranked on other people's ballots. I love it because preseason, it's all based on just projections. So if you're interested in that, you'll be able to see that on our social media channels, hopefully beginning early next week. Be your little tease before you head into the Thanksgiving holidays. So again, both of these teams are warming up, so what we'll do is we'll take a quick break as they continue to warm up. And when we come back, we'll hopefully have the start of the alumni three-point contest. As that comes up and more, as this is Meet the Cougar Night on K105.
Every day, thousands of kids start vaping. And I can't let this happen to my kid. Of course, it's awkward to talk to kids about the dangers of vaping. Hey, bestie. How sketch is vaping? It's hard to get their attention. Ready? Go. Yes. Look at that. You didn't even turn yours over. So if you want to talk to your kids about the dangers of vaping, you have to get it trending. Right, Backpack Kid?
Let's do it.
First, invite your kid to do the vape talk. Let's try this. All right.
Why is he here?
Yeah, I gotta get it trending, no. Honey.
Come on.
Let's go.
Oh, honey, can we talk?
Yeah, what's up?
I see a lot of your friends vaping.
Visit talkaboutvaping.org for tips on when and how to have the vape talk.
Boom. Oh, that stupid controller froze again.
You're spending less money,
so. I wonder if you guys wanted me. OMG, it's McGruff.
Yes, I am.
He's not my Uncle McGruff the Crime Dog. He's a fake.
Oh. I am McGruff the Crime Dog. He is the fake. And so is that controller you're holding. It's gonna break. Let's take a bite out of crime together.
Who says you're not the fake?
Dude, you're literally missing it.
You are smart, kids. You're smart. Buy smart.
With the My Social Security account, you can request a replacement Social Security card, estimate your benefits, and more. Save time. Go online. Open a My Social Security account at ssa.gov/myaccount.
Produced at U.S. taxpayer expense.
When caring for a family member, their state of health is continually on your mind. And when they're faced with a health concern, you'll do just about anything to make them feel better. Rest assured, their feel better starts right here at Midway Pharmacy. We take our time to get to know all about your family's health history so we can provide you with educated advice. So when someone's counting on you to help them maintain a healthy lifestyle or to overcome that untimely sickness, remember,
your feel better starts
at Midway Pharmacy.
The alumni are warming up right now, as you can get a look at them down on the court as we have a kind of a first-person look at what the alumni are doing as they're getting loose on the floor. Again, your alumni that you're going to be seeing shooting, you've got Allie Horton, Phoebe Goldsmith, Alex Majors, Haley Smith, Kelsey Martin, and Chelsea Gilbert that are out there that they'll be shooting going up against some of the current Lady Cougars. And I always love the three-point contest. And I liked the alumni game that they brought in as well that they've done in years past. But this is also fun to kind of see what some of these can still do. And, I mean, listen, you look down at some of the Cougar boys have players that have just played as soon as, oh, last year. Keegan Sharp, who will be going up against River Blanson. Trey Goff just graduated, I don't know, maybe 5 years ago. It's not so recent. Ethan Salzman in the last decade as well. I know that they were talking beforehand that Brett Johnston was potentially going to have to get in there. And as he told me, he said that they didn't want that. He said the players didn't want that because he'd show them up too well. I'm not sure that I necessarily believe that fully, but it looks like we're going to get ready to roll out.
With the lady alumni.
I'll turn it over to Brian Payton to see what he has on the introductions. I guess maybe they're going to go one at a time. We'll see what they're going to do here. I thought they were going to go. It looks like they're just going to go one at a time.
Tonight is going to be Allie Horton.
Looks like they're going to shoot, and the first one will be Allie Horton to shoot for the alumni. We'll keep track here as it looks like they're going to go one at a time.
So these participants will have 15 shots, 1 minute to make the most baskets. Now are you ready, Allie? In 3, 2, 1, go.
So here we come. There's one for Allie Horton. There's two. She misses that off to the left side. 15 shots in 1 minute. She's got two right now. She will go up against Lucy Torrance. Second shot. Oh, it rattles out. I don't know if she got that or not. We'll say it goes in. There's one. Maybe she's found the hot corner. Allie Horton is the player shooting right now for Grayson County. She'll finish with four. It'll be Lucy Torrance who will go up next.
For the girls' high school team. And the winner of the shootout between the Lady Cougars will take on the winner of the boys' shootout, and the winner will be $25. All right, instead of Lucy, it's going to be Lexi Buxton. Lexi, if you're ready. 3, 2, 1, go.
Let me see.
Okay, if he's not here, we'll go next with Alex Majors. Now let's get ready in 3, 2, 1, let her go.
The Isabel Blanton next for Grayson County. I'm not really sure that they're necessarily competing against each other. I think they're just competing as a whole. It's Isabel Blanton for Grayson County right now. She gets that final one. Now moving over into that final corner pocket. Makes it. Trying to get in the roll on that far side. The sophomore, her final ball, just a little short.
Our next alumni shooter is Haley Smith.
Haley Smith will now take her chance. Of course, she is the daughter of head coach Todd Johnston.
In 3, 2, 1, let it go.
There she goes, makes that. Trying to bank it in. Got it. Oh, and nothing but net.
Haley finished with six. She's now
six.
Tied with Alex Majors.
Tied with Alex Majors right now for the lead.
And on the high school team, Riley Renfrew.
Riley Renfrew is now shooting. Renfrew on the far side. She's got four on the clock.
Our next Olympic shooter is Kelsey Martin.
And Kelsey Martin next. Eleanor Valles will follow.
Three, two, one, let it go.
Texas right now. It's Kelsey Martin shooting as a part of the alumni. Nice, pretty last stroke. Martin is two off the lead right now at four. What's the last one go? Got it with five, so she's just one short of the lead. Next up will be Ella Narvaez. Oh, no, it'll be Arissa Riggs, rather. They've gone out of order. Arissa Riggs, probably the second best shooter on the Lady Cougars, right behind Sydney Perkins. Sydney Perkins not participating today. Looks like they're communicating to make sure that everything's right.
Two, one, go.
First one from Marissa Riggs is a little long. There's the first one that rolls in. It was smart there. She was long every single time, so she scooted back on the three and ends up putting that one in. Straight away, she's caught fire. And that's the thing with Marissa Riggs. When she gets rolling, she can catch fire, and there she goes. Three in a row. Can it be four? It just clanks off the back. There's four of five for Arissa Riggs. She's one off the lead. Got it. There's six for the tie. Riggs looking to take the lead in and out. This one would give her the lead. It is good. Riggs takes the lead with seven.
Arissa has taken the lead with seven threes. Our next alumni, Elena Jones.
Elena Jones is going to come out and shoot now, assistant coach. Elena's the JV head coach. She's the wife of head football coach Brian Jones. Their oldest daughter, Bree, is going to be playing on the varsity basketball team this year as a seventh grader. She's a talented little player. You'll be able to see her in just a few moments when the Lady Cougars scrimmage on the floor. Elena's got one right now. She's the other Coach Jones. That one's off the back of the iron. She's got two right now. Well, that one just clanks off the side of the backboard. She wasn't thinking she was going to be participating in here. And that's tough when you're not thinking that you're going to be shooting.
Let's hear it for Coach Jones with two.
Coach Jones finishes with two.
Ella Narvaez.
Ella Narvaez will shoot. Ella is the sophomore.
If you're ready in three, two, one.
Ella had 6 points and nine rebounds last year. Expecting big things from her. She's got good size. She played yesterday and gave some good minutes yesterday in the scrimmage against South Warren. I'm sure we'll talk to Todd Johnson about that in just a moment. She makes the first. Team loves it. She's not necessarily known as a three-point shooter. And she's just a little bit short every time. Almost gets the shooter's roll. Ella will now shift onto the far side. And she's close for not being known as a shooter. She's never attempted a three in her career. She misses that. Next up, Chelsea Gilbert.
The alumni shooter will be Chelsea Gilbert.
Chelsea Gilbert now shooting. She's on pace right now. She's got two. She needs seven. First one, nothing but net from straight away. Second one almost got the shooter's roll. High arcing shot just off to the left. Oh, man, she's just missing. Chelsea Gilbert got it. She's four. She needs three of the last five here. To Ty Riggs. There's one. There's two. She's one off the lead. That one's short. This one would be for Ty. It is just short. Riggs' lead still holds.
Our final shooter tonight for the ladies, Sutton Van Meter.
Sutton Van Meter will now get her chance. Sutton's a little sister of Cougar, wide receiver, running back, do it all, Jaron Van Meter, quarterback even. So he went in for quarterback in the playoff game. She's got one here. She played really well, and she was known as the charge specialist last year for Grayson County. I don't have her official count of charges, but she at one point was just taking charge after charge after charge. And she's on fire from three. Three in a row. Sutton Van Meter showing off some range from three. She's got six. One off the lead for Arissa Riggs. There's seven for the tie. Van Meter on fire with eight. There's nine for Sutton Van Meter. 10 for Sutton Van Meter. How about Sutton Van Meter letting it fly?
Next on the list is time for the boys' three-point shootout. If you guys want to get out there and start warming up some, the Cougar alumni will consist of Trey Goff, Alex Shellhart, Ethan Salzman, Mason Galloway, Bryce Meredith, and Keegan Sharp.
Looks like they're going to let some of the players go out there and warm up, get some shooting done. So with that, a couple of weeks ago, we sat down and we talked to River Blanton for a Cougar conversation for football. We're going to play that now as he's getting warmed up on the floor, and we'll introduce you to River Blanton and some of this Cougar basketball team. As we'll take that and we'll jump into a Cougar conversation right now with River Blanton. Welcome back to the Halftime Show here on K105. It's another edition of our Cougar Conversations. Today, we are being joined by River Blanton, Grayson County High School basketball senior player. And River, first off, thanks for joining us. And second, if you were telling your story of basketball, you know, who you've played for, who you've played with, how long have you been playing, how does it go?
I've played since I was about 5 years old, and I played on a bunch of AAU teams and middle school and high school my whole entire career.
Last year, you all win the district tournament on a buzzer beater. Obviously, you were not the player that hit the shot, but what was that like even celebrating with Hunter?
It was crazy. The student section was just great, and everybody, the crowd was amazing, and just the way that it ended, it was good for our seniors. It was a good, hard-fought win, too.
You got some new faces back to the team and some old faces that have rejoined the team that you didn't have in summer with Dylan, Jack, and Camden. What do they bring to your team that you didn't have in the summer?
They bring a lot of fight. Everybody that's came back and everybody that's on our team is going to fight, and they're going to do their role and what they need to do for our team to be successful.
What have you as a player been doing during this offseason to try and improve your game?
I played with the AAU team from Lexington called Cave Gym Elite all spring and summer. And then we did summer ball, and I've just been working out in the gym and stuff.
This district coming up this year is wide open. There's a lot of really solid – I think all four teams are really solid. What does Grayson County need to do in your team to help keep the district title in Litchfield?
We all just – every day we got to bring intensity, and everybody's got to play their role. And we're just all going to have to play it together to be successful, which I think we're not going to have a problem doing.
As a team, what are some of your goals?
Our goals are to go above 500, to win a Christmas tournament, and obviously to win the district, and then maybe have a run in the region.
I know I'd be remiss if I didn't ask you about some fishing.
Yeah.
You all won the region tournament for fishing for the first time. What was that like?
That was amazing. Traditionally, we're the farthest away from there, so usually we don't do as good as we do, but everybody did good that day, so we won the region. It was pretty exciting.
We'll jump in now to our speed rounds. This will be just quick questions, quick answers. What's your favorite memory as a Cougar?
Probably going to state in the eighth grade.
Pre-game music, what's in your headphones?
I like to listen to Taylor Swift.
Really? Okay, I wouldn't have come up with that. Are you superstitious before game?
No, not really. I like to just hang out with my friends. On a bus ride, I take a nap. That's probably the only thing.
What's your favorite class?
Carpentry.
Carpentry, okay. Cats or dogs?
Dogs.
Good answer. That's the right answer. If your teammates had a Royal Rumble wrestling, who wins?
Me or Dylan Horn.
If your coaches had a Royal Rumble, who wins?
I'm going to have to go Coach Meredith.
I think that's the right answer. Could any of your teammates win American Idol?
Probably Zach Bratcher.
Okay. If your teammates had a strongman competition, who wins?
Probably me.
Would they agree?
Yes.
They're all now corralling around us. Could any of your teammates come close to outfishing you?
No, not a chance.
Who would come second?
Probably Hayden Robinson.
Hayden Robinson, okay. River, I appreciate it. Good luck this season. That has been our Cougar conversation for this week. Our halftime show continues here in just a few moments.
When caring for a family member, their state of health is continually on your mind. And when they're faced with a health concern, you'll do just about anything to make them feel better. Rest assured, their feel better starts right here at Midway Pharmacy. We take our time to get to know all about your family's health history so we can provide you with educated advice. So when someone's counting on you to help them maintain a healthy lifestyle or to overcome that untimely sickness, remember, your feel better starts at Midway Pharmacy.
Hi, can I help you?
I just wanted to say thank you. Bye!
Can I help you?
Yeah, just wanted to say thanks.
For what?
For all the money that's been flying out of your drafty windows and doors this winter. It's just so generous of you. So, we wanted to say thanks.
We?
Yeah, the whole neighborhood's here.
Thank you! Stop throwing your money out the window. Visit us at Future Designs Building Materials on Quarry Road in Litchfield.
We know windows and doors.
The builder's choice.
Here's a simple truth about higher education.
If pursuing your purpose, doing what you really care about matters.
If having a rewarding career matters.
If a better financial future for you and your family matters.
Then higher education matters. A brighter future is within your reach. Find out how at kyhigheredmatters.org. Brought to you by this station and the Kentucky Broadcasters Association.
Navigating the maze of Medicare enrollment can be a confusing and overwhelming experience. State Health Insurance Assistance Programs, or SHIP, are experts on Medicare.
I felt like this place could really help me out.
They were so nice and helpful on the phone. I really do appreciate the fact that they take us seriously.
Local, unbiased, and trusted Medicare help. Contact the SHIP office in your area to make an appointment.
Hi, can I help you?
I just wanted to say thank you. Bye!
Can I help you?
Yeah, just wanted to say thanks.
For what?
For all the money that's been flying out of your drafty windows and doors this winter. It's just so generous of you. So?
Stop throwing your money out the window. Visit us at Future Designs Building Materials on Quarry Road in Litchfield.
We know windows and doors.
The builder's choice.
Welcome back to K105's coverage of Meet the Cougar Night here on K105 Digital Productions. Sam Gormley with you as the boys are warming up right now for an alumni three-point contest. The winner of the Lady Cougars version was Sutton Van Meter. She knocked in, I think it was 10. 10 of 15. As I think they're asking right now, Brian Payton asking if he said, and I quote, the old guys if they're ready. There aren't many old guys out there. The oldest might be Dr. Bryce Meredith. And I'm not sure old is a word I would use to describe Dr. Bryce. Got a good group out there for the Cougar boys. Trey Goff, Alex Schellhart, Ethan Sulzman, Mason Galloway, Bryce Meredith, and Keegan Sharp. For the Cougar boys shooting, it'll be Dylan Horn, Camden Brothers, Lucas Pierce, Braden Childress, Bentley Martin, and River Blanson. As looks like they're about ready to roll. They're going to set it up. This time they're going to be shooting on the right side of the floor. But doesn't look like they're going to be going against one another. It looks like they're just going to set it up and do one at a time, similar to what they did for the Lady Cougars. Again, the Cougar boys tomorrow will be hosting scrimmages all day tomorrow here at the Cougar Den. Game start at 11 a.m. as Whitesville Trinity will take on Atherton. At 1 o'clock, it'll be Ohio County against Metcalf County. Breck County will take on Monroe County following that at 3. At 5 o'clock, it'll be Davis County against Greenwood. And then to close out the night, just about 24 hours from right now, Grayson County will take on Hart County. At 7 o'clock, there'll be JV in between all of those games as well. As we'll see here who is shooting first. I believe they did say Trey Goff is going to let fly first for the Cougars.
All right, Trey. One, go.
Trey Goff shoots first. Goff holds the Grayson County record for career for threes made in a single season. In his first round, can't find the bottom of the net. Just a little off to the right, Trey Goff trying to find the stroke. Last year I know he had a very successful run. There's the first one. That's the thing with a shooter. When the first one goes in, there starts the run as there's two for Trey Goff. Can't get the third in a row. I think we need to set it up next year where we got the, like in the NBA, they got the golden ball at the end, or like in the home run derby where you make the last one, you get 10 more seconds, I think, or something like that is what they've done on you hit the last home run. Can't make that one. Well, I guess that's not even a thing in the home run derby anymore because they've gone to time instead of outs. So I guess that's no longer a thing, but still, we need to figure out something. So Trey Goff finishes with three. He'll go up against Dylan Horn, but again, it's not really necessarily a direct matchup. Well, now Dylan Horn's, he's broke out the number 22 again. He's gone back and forth between the 44 and the 22. Not sure if he's going to go the double deuce or the double fours. Dylan Horn didn't play basketball in the summer. Back, though, playing, and he makes his first three. There's two. There's three for Dylan Horn. Dylan Horn, three threes on his first trip. Sure, he's probably going to be sending this tape to head coach Travis Johnston saying, hey, let me step out there and shoot the three sometimes. He's hit four. There's five for Dylan Horn. He's feeling it. Dylan Horn with five threes. The record right now is 10 made by sophomore Sutton Van Meter. And Horn's gone cold on the far side. Makes that for six. Trying to make it seven, can't get it to roll in. Should be Alex Shellhart to shoot next. Shellhart to step out, and he'll let it fly.
Three, two, one, go.
Just a little short on the first one for the alumni. As a whole, I know if you're watching on K105 Digital Productions, our scoreboard is keeping track of alumni versus Cougar. It's just for our pure entertainment. And the girls, it was tied 25-25, I believe. I don't know what it is right now. As a whole, I think it's probably Cougars up. It's 6-6, I guess, overall. I can't see the scoreboard. You watching can. Now the alumni have taken a lead, but they've also taken more threes. Shellhart from the top of the key. Oh, gets it to roll in. Shellhart from the far side. He's got good rebounders underneath. Like some of the younger guys are making them get out there and rebound the basketball. Shellhart's got six right now, which is tied for the lead with Dylan Horn, and that's where he's going to finish off. Now it'll be Camden Brothers. Brothers, also a baseball player, a little outfield primarily for the Cougar baseball team. He'll also pitch. Like to throw him out there and clean up. As a hitter as well. brothers didn't play basketball last season for the Cougars. He's back this year. And he brings a different style to this Cougar team as he's, for one, as you can see, about 6'3", 6'4", give or take. Athletic, lengthy, long arms. He is something that you can't teach. That's size. And the Cougars, you can never have too much of it. And I'll be interested to see what role he will hold in this Cougar team here, as he's got the lead right now with 7 threes overall. Make that 8. He's going for Sutton Van Meter, but she's not going to get there. As he finished with 9, one off of the Van Meter lead. It'll be Ethan Salzman now to come out and shoot. Salzman, not necessarily known as a shooter, more of a post player when he played for the Cougars about 10 years ago. He is also the Cougars soccer coach right now. He's ready to roll. Not sure how many threes Coach Salzman took in his career, but I'm assuming not many. Trying to get the stroke going. Makes the first. See if that'll get the rhythm going. There's 2 in a row for Salzman. Can it be 3? The rim is not friendly to the big man. Salzman moving over towards the far side. Lucas Pierce is on deck for Grayson. Salzman airballs that, and he'll finish with 2. No, he's got 1 more. Can he end on a high note? No, right ahead of the buzzer. Salzman finishes with 2. It'll be Lucas Pierce. Pierce had 6 appearances last season for the Cougar boys. Pierce to shoot. Made the first one. I know we talked with Brett Johnston, assistant coach, before the game. He was saying Lucas Pierce has been feeling it in practice as of late. He was kind of the one that the alumni especially were worried about a lot. He's got 5. And he is, I mean, the rim is not friendly to the shooter. He's got 6, but really he could have about 9. There's 7. He's got 8. That ties brothers at 9. And he airballs the last one, so he's tied with Camden brothers. Sutton Van Meter still has the overall lead at 10. The overall scoreboard is Cougars 24, alumni 11. But the epitome of shooters has now hit the floor right now. Mason Galloway. And first one, nothing but net for Galloway. How about the second one for Galloway? Oh, he can't make a 3 in a row. Mason Galloway puts it in. 3 of 5 for Mason Galloway. He's on pace to try and take the lead here. Can't get the roll. Galloway lets it ride in. 5 for Galloway. Galloway's got 6. Looking for 7. Got it. Mason Galloway is on pace to maybe take the lead. There's 8. There's 9 for Galloway for the lead. Can't get it. He's still tied overall. That one for the lead. Got it. Galloway's taking the lead. And now he's taking it overall. 11 of 15 shooting for Mason Galloway. And he now points at Braden Childress and says he warmed it up for him. Braden Childress. If you were listening this morning on our morning show in the know, Christy picked Mason Galloway as the winner. She's looking very smart right now as he's got the overall. He's tied with Sutton Van Meter for the overall lead. Braden Childress trying to heat up. And he is doing just that, nothing but net. There's 7, or 6 rather, for Childress. There's seven. I was just predicting the future. Seven for Braden Childress. Eight. Nine. 10. This would be to tie Galloway. No! Galloway's record continues. Childress almost made the comeback. Dr. Bryce Meredith comes up. He's going to take his shots now.
Bryce, if you're ready, go.
First one for Meredith is good. Second one just a little long for Dr. Bryce. Gets that one in. Two for Meredith to start. Three for Meredith. He's got a smooth stroke. There it is. Looks like the scoreboard might have froze up. I'm not sure what he's at right now. I think he's at four. Scoreboard appears to have frozen. If there's a time for it to freeze, it's good that it would freeze during a three-point contest. I think that's five for Meredith. Looks like Bryce.
Seven.
I can't even count. That's seven for Bryce Meredith. Sorry, Bryce. I was way off on your count there.
All right, up for the boys, Bentley Martin.
Be Bentley Martin now to shoot. Standing on deck as the all-time three-point leader in Cougar basketball history.
Three, two, one, go.
Bentley Martin. Martin is a senior. No appearances in games last season. Here's the first one. There's two for Martin. Three. Four. Five for Bentley Martin. Six for Martin. Seven. Martin is heat up, but it's going to be a little too late. He's got seven right now. That'll make it eight. Looks like they turned the scoreboard off. Keegan Sharp now up. And if you've watched Cougar basketball over the past couple of years, you know Keegan can flat out shoot. And I think the biggest thing here is if the first one goes in, Mason Galloway's probably going to hold his head low, and it doesn't. Misses the first two. There goes the first one. I think Galloway just hopes that Sharp doesn't get into a roll, because he's seen it, that when Keegan gets into that roll, that's when the records can start falling. Galloway, he's going to hold it. Because Keegan Sharp would have to make every single one. Four for Keegan. Oh, he missed it. So Mason Galloway's lead is going to hold. He takes down the all-time leading three-point shooter. We could have Mason Galloway against Sutton Vingenmeter for the championship. I tell you, when I talked to Mason beforehand, he had quiet confidence about it. Keegan with six. And the final one is going to be River Blanton. He needs 11 to tie Mason Galloway.
Have to beat 11.
To go up against Sutton Van Meter.
Two, one, go.
First one good for Blanton. Second one. Three for Blanton. So he's got to pick up the pace. He's got to catch fire from straight away. Blanton with five. I believe if I can do math, well, he'd have to make all of these to tie Mason Galloway. If not, Galloway advances to the championship. And he does not. It'll be Mason Galloway against Sutton Van Meter for the championship coming up. An alumni against Lady Cougar. Tell you what, Sutton Van Meter, she was letting them fly too. Blanton will finish with six.
Now
Now the shootout between the girls and the boys. The winners of the girls was Sutton Vanfinger with 10. She'll be taking on alumni Mason Galloway, who ended with 11. The winner of this shootout will receive a $25.
So it'll be Mason Galloway against Sutton Van Meter for the championship. See who's going to go first. They're going to let Mason Galloway shoot, see if he can still have the hot hand. Looks like he is going to take out, and he's going to go first. Or are they going to go at the same time? I hope they go at the same time. I like that in the past. Yeah, they are going to go at the same time. So it's perfect. We got Cougars and alumni. Are we going to go at the same time? Nope, they are going to go one at a time. Mason Galloway. He's got one. Two for Galloway. Three for Galloway. Oh, misses it to end three straight, but he goes four out of five. Tell you what, Mason Galloway, I'm not sure if that's Mason Galloway or Steph Curry. Even though I don't think Steph Curry quite has the three-point percentage that Galloway has tonight. Puts that in. Galloway with six. So Mason Galloway's got six. Sutton Van Meter had 10 in the first. Mason Galloway as a whole has 17 threes. Oh, well, that one pops out. The rim is not friendly to the alum. And Galloway's going to finish with nine.
All right, he's going to finish with nine.
So as a whole, that's 20 out of 30 shooting, 66.7% for Mason Galloway, which that's pretty good. That'll get it done. It's not going to be Sutton Van Meter to get her chance. She needs nine to tie. She got in a roll. She missed her first couple when she took it the last time. She can't get quite the roll. There it is. Van Meter needs to go. And that's it. Mason Galloway is going to win. The alumni are going to take down, and it's Mason Galloway, as picked this morning on In the Know by Christy Buckles. She picks Mason, and Mason makes her look like Nostradamus, as Van Meter is going to finish with two.
And the winner of the alumni three-point shootout goes to Mason Galloway.
Mason Galloway is the winner. How about that? That's what we love to see. Mason Galloway picks up the win. And that, I mean, you love it. You absolutely love it. We're going to take a break, and when we come back, we're going to talk to the man himself, assistant coach Brett Johnston, get you introduced to the Cougar boys as that comes up in that and more. This is Meet the Cougar Night on K105.
When caring for a family member, their state of health is continually on your mind. And when they're faced with a health concern, you'll do just about anything to make them feel better. Rest assured, their feel better starts right here at Midway Pharmacy. We take our time to get to know all about your family's health history so we can provide you with educated advice. So when someone's counting on you to help them maintain a healthy lifestyle or to overcome that untimely sickness, remember,
your feel better starts
at Midway Pharmacy.
Connection. It's the name of the game in Grayson County schools. Connection with students, with colleagues, with community, through relationships, through partnerships, through small daily acts, through high impact programs at all levels. Connections that teach, that encourage, that build confidence, that show together we can, preparing students for life equipped with real and real world skills for success. Together, we are GC Connected.
Welcome back here to the Cougar Den, Grayson County High School. I'm joined now by the winner of the alumni of the three-point shooting contest, Mason Galloway. Mason, I told you beforehand that Christy, on this morning show, she picked you. She was confident. I mean, you were feeling it, weren't you?
Yeah, I was feeling pretty good.
Now, sure, I mean, Keegan Sharp, all-time leading three-point shooter. You didn't just beat him. You slaughtered him.
He's a little out of practice. I play a couple times a week, so.
But still, that's got to be a little smack talk, isn't there?
Yeah, just a little bit.
Trey Goff as well has the all-time. He has the most threes in a single season. Beat him.
I don't know what to say. It's just.
You're speechless, right?
I was feeling it. It felt good out there.
You were talking with Brett Johnston beforehand. Was he giving you some pointers? No,
he knows I can shoot. He's on my team in the men's league I play in. He sets me up for a lot of good looks.
I see here your former coach, Coach Jay, he comments and he says, Galloway is a stone-cold shooter.
That's right.
Now, do you have anything to tell him on why you didn't play more, seeing what you shoot?
No, I can't guard. So.
Mason, congratulations on the win. It's good to see you. And I see. Oh, Mr. Spirit has just walked in the building. We're going to have to turn around and let him have the moment. Mr. Spirit has walked in. And that is exactly what that is the best sign that you could possibly see. Mr. Spirit has just walked in the building. He hasn't been in a game. If you have not been aware, he's been battling cancer. And to say that's a good sign to see him is the biggest understatement in the world. That's great to see him. He's masked up. That's really good to see him out there. I wasn't expecting to see him today, and he just walked into the building. The night has been dedicated to him, and he is here. That's a really, really good sign. We will take a one-minute break, and when we come back, we will hopefully talk to head coach Brett Johnston, as this is Meet the Cougar Night on K105.
When caring for a family member, their state of health is continually on your mind. And when they're faced with a health concern, you'll do just about anything to make them feel better. Rest assured, their feel better starts right here at Midway Pharmacy. We take our time to get to know all about your family's health history so we can provide you with educated advice. So when someone's counting on you to help them maintain a healthy lifestyle or to overcome that untimely sickness, remember,
your feel better starts
at Midway Pharmacy.
Hi, can I help you?
Bye.
Can I help you?
Yeah, just wanted to say thanks.
For what?
For all the money that's been flying out of your drafty windows and doors this winter. It's just so generous of you. So, we wanted to say thanks.
We?
Yeah, the whole neighborhood's here.
Thank you. Stop throwing your money out the window. Visit us at Future Designs Building Materials on Quarry Road in Litchfield.
We know windows and doors.
The builder's choice.
Here's a simple truth about higher education.
If pursuing your purpose, doing what you really care about matters.
If having a rewarding career matters.
If a better financial future for you and your family matters.
Then higher education matters. A brighter future is within your reach. Find out how at kyhigheredmatters.org. Brought to you by this station and the Kentucky Broadcasters Association.
Oh, that stupid controller froze again.
Spending less money,
I was wondering if you guys wanted me. OMG, it's McGruff!
Yes, I am.
He's not my Uncle McGruff the Crime Dog! He's a fake!
I am McGruff the Crime Dog. He is the fake. And so is that controller you're holding. It's gonna break. Let's take a bite out of crime together.
Who says you're not the fake?
Dude, you're literally missing it.
You are smart, kids. You're smart. Buy smart.
Welcome back here to the Cougar Den, Grayson County High School's Meet the Cougar Night. I'm joined now by two of the seniors, Braden Childress and River Blanton. Guys, appreciate you joining us. I know we'll talk to Brett here, but the first thing I got to ask is, how about Mason Galloway?
Yeah.
Did you all know he could stroke it like that?
Oh, yeah.
Now, did you all think he could beat Keegan?
He's been shooting pretty good lately.
Now, Braden, you also had some stroke. Has that been something you've been working on?
Yeah.
The three-point game?
Mm-hmm.
I know you've been battling a little bit of a knee injury. You feeling good, though, tonight?
Yeah. I just got cleared by Dr. Meredith Friday today, and he said I'm good to go, and I'm just 100% now.
Now, River, I know we talked a couple of weeks ago, and in fact, we just played it again here a few moments ago on kind of introducing this team. So, Brayden, I'm going to ask you and kind of get your thoughts. This team is, you've got some returning faces, you've got some new faces. How do you feel about the team this year?
I love it. I love the team. We got so much depth this year, and just we're so big and long.
that defense is just going to be so much better.
River, your eighth graders. You've got some young guys, Jack. You've got Caden. You got Spencer. What do those guys bring to this team?
They bring.
Turn you here. There you go.
They bring a lot to this team. The other day in the scrimmage, Jack had 20 and Caden had 10 and 4 assists. They really know how to play. They can put the ball on the rim and they're not afraid of anything. They'll go at everybody, so they're great to have on our team.
Brayden, this district really intrigues me because I think, I mean, you look, you all are the defending champs back to back. That means something. Butler County added a really, really good player that you all saw last year at South Warren and Ty Price. Whitesville Trinity, you all know them. They're really good. Huff, he can really play. And then Edmondson County hosts the district, and as you all know, anytime you all play Edmondson County, it doesn't matter if you all haven't won a game and they're undefeated or vice versa. It's going to be a battle. How do you see the district? What do you think about those teams and moving forward?
I think we got a pretty good shot. I like the feeling of our team. I think if we come out ready, we'll be all right.
Now, River, Coach Jay, he's watching right now. He can't be here right now. Do you have any messages for him? I know he just added a new member to the family today. Or you could say something because he can't clap back right now.
Over the last 4 years, he's been a great coach. When he was freshmen, he brought us in, always pushed us to do our best we could, and it made us a lot better. And over the years, he's just been a great coach to have.
Brayden, I think that's a really good point that River just made, is that 3 years ago when you all were freshmen, it wasn't the strongest season. I mean, I think you still made the district championship game and still got to play in the region tournament. But how did you all playing that much as freshmen, do you think, benefited you going into the senior year now?
Just so much reps. Just being able to bring up the ball when I was so young, I think that helped me the most. And now, like, I feel like I can just get around anybody, and because I've had so many reps, I've got the guys around me to be able to get them open shots. And
River, adding Camden Brothers back into the loop, I know you aren't the same player, but at least similar size, yeah. As far as height-wise, how does that make you better?
It makes us a lot better because, as Camden just showed right there, that he can stroke the three, so they didn't see Camden last year and they didn't see Camden this summer, so I think that teams might try to double off him onto me in the post, and if I kick it back out, I have full faith that he's putting it in the rim.
Brayden, this season, what's your goal? What's the team goal? What do you want to see when we talk again, maybe in late February, early March? I can never remember when it is.
I want to win district and then make a run in region.
Seems like that's probably the same thing for you too, River. Individual goals for either one of you. Do you all do that? Point mark, assists?
Get as many assists as possible.
Is there points per game or rebounds for you, River?
I'd like to reach my 1,000 and get my 500 rebounds.
You're close on both, aren't you?
Yeah. I should get the 500 rebounds before Christmas, and my 1,000 points should be somewhere after that.
Well, I appreciate both of you all. Good luck this season. November the 29th is coming real quick, and I guess we got to talk to that man over there, right? Is there anything you want to say about him?
He's a great coach. When I was an eighth grader, well, me and Brayden both, we wasn't physically strong. We knew how to play basketball, and we always went hard at it. But he brought us in, got us lifting, got us in drills, got us shooting, fixed our shots. With that guy right there, I wouldn't be half as good of a basketball player as I am now.
Well, I appreciate it for both of you all. Good luck this season. We'll talk to you again at some point probably, and we'll talk to that man right there. That's River Blanton and Brayden Childress. We'll take a 30-second break and have Brett Johnson.
When caring for a family member, their state of health is continually on your mind. And when they're faced with a health concern, you'll do just about anything to make them feel better. Rest assured, their feel better starts right here at Midway Pharmacy. We take our time to get to know all about your family's health history so we can provide you with educated advice. So when someone's counting on you to help them maintain a healthy lifestyle or to overcome that untimely sickness, remember.
Welcome back here to the Cougar Den. Sam Gormley back here with you, now joined by assistant coach Brett Johnston. And Brett, first off, it's good to see you. Coach B, you know, I got to drop that in there, and I'm sure fans are wondering, wait a second, you're not Travis.
Nope, I'm not.
You are here because you have another nephew, right?
Yes, I do. Brock Johnston. I haven't seen him yet. I'll go see him tomorrow. But
everybody's healthy, right?
Yes, as far as I know. We haven't got no bad texts, so. As now, everybody's in good shape.
I know he's locked in and watching right now.
Is he posting stuff?
He is. He says first thing he says is can't let Mason get hot.
Cannot.
And then he says he's a stone cold shooter.
He is a stone cold shooter.
And I mean, I can't disagree. I saw it right there. He can really let it fly. And last season, your team won your second straight district title. Mm-hmm. Missed out though again on getting that win in the region tournament. How do you work towards getting over that hump this year?
I think this season, especially in this summer, we struggled rebounding. We brought some guys back, Dylan, Jack, Camden, to help us with that. I feel like this year we'll run a little bit better offense. I think we're longer on the defensive end. I think rebounding won't be an issue. I think we have a lot of experience back, too, with Dylan, Braden, Jack, River, some other guys that you wouldn't really think of, but played a lot of varsity. Dylan's been starting since he's a freshman, Braden, River, all of them. And I think it'll be a little bit easier for them to gel with the offense we're running. It'll make easy plays for us. And I just think right now being together is the best thing about our team. I don't see any jealousy. Not that I've said we've seen any in the past, but I don't see any jealousy. We're all unselfish. Everybody's making the extra pass, and Taylor County will look pretty good, and we're looking to build on that tomorrow, and we're just trying to get better each and every day because I think our ceiling this year is a little high because we're putting some new guys in there. When a little shooter boy down there in the boot gets back too, he can shoot the lights out of it. And our role players this year, every single one of them can put the ball in the basket. And they are fighters. I said everybody on this team, they play as hard as they can. They play defense, and they just fight.
I saw y'all play a few times in summer ball. It was different, completely different team mm-hmm. from what you have right now. You didn't have Dylan. You didn't have Camden. Didn't have Jack at that point. And I'm sure that there were more people that still weren't there mm-hmm. as well. It was different. How do you still use that summer ball to your advantage, even though that it was – I mean, your team today is completely different.
I think you use it as motivation. I think getting our butts beat a little bit, pretty bad some games this summer, putting some younger guys in spots that wasn't really fair to throw them in against Bowling Green and some other good teams we played this summer. But it didn't hurt because they got to compete against better competition. And now, since their roles are a little bit lessened, it helps them. They can go in and just play free. They don't have to make something happen. All they got to do is just play their role and be easy, especially with guys like Dylan and Jack and them back to help the scoring load, and Camden too. I just think it's going to be a lot easier on the role players that probably started a lot this summer. And I think these guys that are coming back are ready to take a big step up, starting with River Blandon, all the way down from Dylan to Braden. All of them are ready to take a big step up. I think we're going to have a pretty good season.
Cat's Paws didn't rank you all in the top 10. You are, I'm not sure, are aware of this, but something that's starting this year is a third region media poll where all of the media representatives from around the region are going to be voting as well. And I can give you a little bit of a tease right now in that poll, since I'm the one putting it together, you all are 10th. Now, there's still a few more votes out there. I know Travis, your older brother, built bulletin board material isn't something that he necessarily thrives on. Do you care about that, or do you think your team cares that people aren't taking them seriously?
I think our team cares. You know, River, Dylan, and any of them in there, they care a lot about where we are ranked as a team. Not really individually, but as a team, they care a lot. Me, you can use it as fuel. I don't really care what anybody but the 15 guys in that locker room think and our coaching staff. But I've never really been much about that. Me and Travis are about the same. If you want them to put you higher, you need to go out there and prove it, win some games. That's all there is to it. If you want to prove why you're a top five team in the region, you got to go knock off who they have up there. That's all you can really do to get some attention.
Your schedule this year is not as hard as last year. I know that was one of the things that even leading into last season, I think Travis was telling me that I think Coach Hill was especially telling him, like, before the year, like, hey, you really want this schedule? Like, it might have been. And I think part of that saw on the record that, I mean, your record, about 500, but you played a brutal schedule last season. This year, it's not easy by any means, but I know it is toned down. I mean, you still play Central Hardin on the road, who might be the best team in the 5th region. You got a team from Tennessee, I know, in one of your holiday tournaments that I know very little about, but I think from what you all have heard, pretty solid.
Pretty good.
Pretty solid team. Region, play them. What do you think about the schedule? I mean, it's easier. I use, you know, quotation marks around that.
I think last year is probably the toughest schedule I've seen, maybe beside Travis's senior year. But I would have to say last year takes the cake. Probably the toughest schedule in school history. I think this year, I don't think there's a game I look at on the schedule and go, well, we don't have a chance of winning. Last year, Pulaski and a couple of those teams, you thought you had a chance to win, but it was a little bit far out because those teams were so good. I mean, probably played four, five, six top 25 teams in the state. I mean, it's really tough. But this year, I think it's more even. I think we can lose any game on that schedule, but I think we can also win any game on that schedule because the region, people don't think it's as good, but I think it's a lot more balanced from top to bottom. I think you take the top two or three teams, you go look 4 through 12 or 13, anybody can beat anybody. And then on a given night, you can beat the top teams if you play well. So I think it's easier, but it's still challenging because Travis never puts together an easy schedule. I don't think he ever will. He's like me. But I think we could really surprise some people if you win some games early, get some confidence. I think that kind of hurt us last year not winning a couple of those close games early. But we win some games early, get some confidence, win some Christmas tournament games and get rolling, I think with this team, the more confident they are, the better chances we're going to have to win. And we're really going to surprise some people, I truly believe.
Now, that tough schedule can benefit you all, and I think it shows, especially when it comes to district tournaments, because I know that there are teams in the district and in the region that don't schedule very hard at all, and I'm not naming names. They know who they are. And I think it benefits you all in the long run, doesn't it?
Yes, I think when you look at it, and I'm not going to mouth any district teams, we usually have the toughest schedule in our district. I think when it gets down to nut crunching time and you're down, our kids know how to fight back. When you play these really tough teams and you get down, it is really difficult to come back. I mean, you see it. Anytime we play Millenburg and we're down, they're not going to beat themselves. Any of these tough teams we play, really if you dig yourself a hole, you're pretty much done. And we dug ourselves a hole in district last year, and we were able to come back twice because we've been in those situations. And these guys have a bad habit of getting down. Taylor County, we got down 11-2 the other day. I don't think it's lack of focus. I just think they're so pumped up. Stuff starts going the other way. But I think as far as – well, Sam, I'm going to be honest. I forgot the question.
Well, I was saying you're –
hey, this is first time.
It's okay.
A camera shot right here, Sam.
No, here, we'll just jump into the next one because you answered it. You answered it. It was good. Holiday tournaments. I know before Christmas, you're playing at Ohio County. You're playing three teams. You know those three teams. What is it? Warren East, Chattanooga School of the Arts and Science, I think is what it's called. And then you've got North Hardy Christian or Classical Christian, whatever it might be. And then after Christmas, you're hosting a holiday tournament. I know game one, you've got Glasgow. And then game two is Bullitt Central or Nicholas County, I believe. And then you've also got on the other side, I'm going to start naming off teams, it's South Warren. But still, it doesn't matter. We'll talk about Davis County is in there. I'm sure Coach Jay is watching right now, yelling at us, saying, "Yeah, it's this one, it's that one."
But he would know.
Those holiday tournaments, so especially getting to host one, I love holiday tournaments. I think they're a lot of fun. Last year, you played in the championship of both of them, lost to two. That Pulaski County team, I mean, still that day, I think they could have beaten the Los Angeles Lakers. It felt like the way that they were playing that day. But do you like holiday tournaments, and what do you think you learn about your team?
I love them. You can figure out a lot about your team in holiday tournaments. It's just you and them. Not a lot of practices. Back-to-back-to-back-to-back games usually. You got three games or four games. Figure out a lot about them because there's no school. You get up. Got to get yourself mentally prepared and ready for the day. But I think – I treat holiday tournaments when I play just as a normal game because that's what it is. But it gives these guys sort of a tournament feel, and they really like the tournament feel of being in a tournament. You got to win to advance. I know Ohio County's not like that. I think it's just round robin three. But our home tournament where it's set up, our guys are going to be pretty antsy to play because they know it's a tournament set up. You win, you advance. You lose, you go to losing bracket. They don't want that.
Against Butler County this year, at the home game, you all are going to be honoring the 1993 championship team, a team that obviously they did something that no one else had ever done. They won the championship here at the Cougar Den when they actually did the smart thing and rotated region tournaments. But that's a conversation we can have for another day. But what's that going to be like to bring in guys? Ernie Perkins, I saw him earlier. He was walking around. I'm sure Superintendent Robinson is probably in here, a couple of the other ones. I'm sure Coach Lee. I think
he's
I saw him
somewhere.
Earlier. He's here somewhere.
He's over there in the corner.
I was going to say, yeah, he's usually
– that's Bill Lee's corner right there.
Yeah, he's usually somewhere. It's either there or down in that corner. But that's going to be a lot of fun, isn't it?
Yeah, I love honoring alumni. I love when an alumni comes out and supports. I love talking to them. I love all the old stories. That's probably my favorite thing about being a part of a program. You see a lot of these guys that just graduated not too long ago come out and do the shooting, Keegan, Mason. Saltzman, Shellhart, a bunch of them. I just love it. That's probably my favorite thing. When you build a good program with a good culture like Travis has, you have kids come back, support. They want to be out here. They want to help the kids. Alex Shellhart came out to practice the other day and helped the kids. As far as the 93 team, I don't know a whole lot of them. I know Ernie. I know Mr. Robinson. I better call him that. Better not call him his first name.
Superintendent Robinson.
Yeah,
yes.
He may get on me if I call him his first name. But I'll be trying to talk to some of them, hear some old stories of when they played. And I know it was kind of upset when we won, but it was hosted here back when we hosted the regions. And they beat a Brett County team that ends up going to win the state tournament in 2 years later. So I would like to hear how good the teams were when they played them, Breck and some of them.
Beat Owensboro in the in the semifinals in one or two overtimes.
Double overtime,
I was going to say. And I think I heard that night in here, I think it felt like it was 150 degrees.
We probably bought some Celtics. We probably smoked them out. So we probably turned off the AC in order to win that game.
You know what? Whatever. That's why it's now at the Sports Center.
Yep.
That's why they're moving it around. The district, to me, is fascinating. Since I've been here, this is now year five for me. I think it's the most interesting the district has been. You look at Whitesville Trinity. They returned pretty much their entire team. I know they lost, and the kid's name is now escaping me.
Right.
Yep. Big kid who could shoot. But they return Huff. They return Hernandez. They pretty much return everything else. Butler County adds a really good player in Ty Price who can flat out shoot. And then Edmondson County, well, it's Edmondson County. They're hosting the district tournament, which, again, crazy things happen when they host the district tournament. Sorry, Coach Mack. Hopefully he didn't hear that. How do you read into this district? Obviously, and then you all, you're the defending champs.
It's wide open, especially if, let's say, you get a one seed and Edmondson's a four and you go down there and you're playing a first round or a two or three matchup. You're on their home court, even if I haven't seen any teams play or nothing. Haven't heard nothing about them. Didn't really pay attention much this summer, but you never know. Whitesville always seems to give us some trouble. We always seem to have to claw and fight back because they play so hard. And Butler adding Price, along with Rice, is a pretty dang good duo in the district. So I think we propose the biggest mismatches with our size. I think if we throw out a lineup of Jack 6'5", River 6'5", Dylan 6'2 or 3", and Camden 6'4", I don't know how teams match up with us size-wise. So I think we propose the biggest mismatches. But right now, I would like to say we're the favorite, but Whitesville returns everybody. I'm not big into who's the favorite and who's not. We're out here. We have to go prove something to the rest of the district on who's the best. Get the one seed, which is really a big goal of ours that we haven't always done. We didn't do last year, as you know. But seeds are thrown out the window come tournament time. If you go 6-0, it doesn't matter. Once the tournament starts, you're 0-0. So it's wide open. I think we have a very good chance to win it, and I'll leave it at that.
I mean, if you put it this way, last season this Lady Cougar team, they went 0-6 in the district, played a Butler County team on their home floor that was 6-0, and the Lady Cougars were in it early in the fourth quarter. That game they played incredibly well and just ran out of gas at the end. It just shows that anything can happen come district tournament time. That's why I love it so much. Your eighth graders, kind of want to wrap up with them. You got Jack. You mentioned Spencer, who can really shoot it. Hanshaw, Caden, what do you see from them? We've known Jack, so we can leave Jack out, but the other eighth graders you're going to be seeing coming up, what do you see from them?
They're very talented. They're very talented. They all three work as hard as anybody in the gym. I'm really pleased with what Jack and Caden shown, and I know what Spencer's about. I've seen him this summer. He's always working out on his game, so those three combined as a class group, I would say one of the best ones we've had in quite some time. I think Rivers Bunch was really, really, really good in middle school. But those three are as good as three players as you're going to find, and they're all in the eighth grade. And they all have a very good chance of playing a lot of varsity. I said there's not really many weaknesses with all three. It's hard to say how good they'll get because they're 13 years old, 14 years old. But the potential's there. They all three work hard. They all got great attitudes, stay out of trouble. So we'll see where they go. I've seen the big improvements from Caden and Jack when they've been here. And I know this summer, by the start of the summer, where Spencer had zero his first game to the last four games of summer, where he's getting 20 points the last four games of summer, these kids are just going to keep getting better and better, and they're really going to help us down the stretch toward district tournament time.
Last question I'll ask you, because I know you got to go down and coach. I asked River. I don't know if you saw his Cougar conversation.
I did. I watched it.
I asked him about his Royal Rumble for coaches. And he picked. He said Coach Meredith would win the Royal Rumble. Is this your opportunity to disagree, or are you saying could you take Coach Meredith, or who's winning the Royal Rumble for coaches?
Coaches or players?
Coaches. I'm saying he said the coaches. He said Coach Meredith and didn't hesitate. You're taking even down Travis.
Yeah. He'll pose here in a second, but players though. Yeah, players. I'm going River.
He
can
River
diss me.
Or
he can
Dylan.
Diss me, but. Yeah, you put them two in a cage together, you don't know what's going to happen. There's been practices where they clothesline each other. They've calmed it down a bunch since then, but when they were younger, you didn't know. If somebody got stolen from them or thought they got fouled, you're coming to the other end, you don't know what's going to happen. Somebody's going to get knocked down. But
I appreciate it. Good luck this year. Maybe we'll get to talk again at some point this year.
After Travis watches this, he's probably not going to let me on here very much anymore.
District championship again, right? Just like last year.
Yeah, hey, there's a lot of questions on there. That's too much for me. I don't have the college education that Travis does. So.
We'll take a break. We'll talk to Coach Todd Johnson after this, as this is the Meet the Cougar Night on K105.
Navigating the maze of Medicare enrollment can be a confusing and overwhelming experience. State Health Insurance Assistance Programs, or SHIP, are experts on Medicare.
I felt like this place could really help me out.
They were so nice and helpful on the phone. I really do appreciate the fact that they take us seriously.
Local, unbiased, and trusted Medicare help. Contact the SHIP office in your area to make an appointment.
Here's a simple truth about higher education.
If pursuing your purpose, doing what you really care about matters.
If having a rewarding career matters.
If a better financial future for you and your family matters.
Then higher education matters. A brighter future is within your reach. Find out how at kyhigheredmatters.org. Brought to you by this station and the Kentucky Broadcasters Association.
Hi, can I help you?
I just wanted to say thank you. Bye.
Can I help you?
Yeah, just wanted to say thanks.
For what?
For all the money that's been flying out of your drafty windows and doors this winter. It's just so generous of you. So, we wanted to say thanks.
We?
Yeah, the whole neighborhood's here.
Thank you.
Stop throwing your money out the window. Visit us at Future Designs Building Materials on Quarry Road in Litchfield.
We know windows and doors.
The builder's choice.
Welcome back here to the Cougar Den. Sam Bormley with you as we have now joined by the head coach of the Grayson County Lady Cougars, head coach Todd Johnston. And coach, first off, good to see you again. It seems like we were just talking at Butler County yesterday after the district tournament. Time flies, doesn't it?
Yeah, it really flies when you're having fun. At least that's what they tell me.
This time a year ago, I asked you a question, and it's a question I love to ask coaches. It's about defining success for a team. Every team's different on the way you define success, and I think you said your answer was something along the lines of that you were not going to define success on wins and losses. Not saying you didn't want to win, but just saying that you wanted to be better on February the whatever it was than you were on November the whatever it was. Was last season successful?
In that regard, yes. From the beginning of the year when we started to the end of the year, you know, I went back and I looked, and we lost 9 games under 10 points, and we lost 18. No, I'll take that back. We lost 9 games when we held our opponents under 45 points, and we lost 18 games when we held our opponents under 50 points, I think. So, you know, it's one of those things that we knew we were going to be offensively challenged, and we were. We would get good shots in games, and we just didn't make them. But, you know, we were down 1 to a team that won 25 games at the district tournament on their home court going into the fourth quarter. So we got better, obviously. I think that speaks for itself. And, you know, then, you know, they ended up beating us 12 because we committed 9 turnovers, I believe, in the fourth quarter. But we got better throughout the year. We got better this summer. We've gotten better since practice started October 15th. And, you know, we're going to have a different year this year. I'd like to be able to say, hey, we're going to get 10, 15, 20 wins, but I don't know that. But I do know we're better, and success will look different for us this time.
I got to see you all play in the summer a couple of times. The game that I think now that I'm thinking about it, I think it was only once because you know you all went on the road a lot, and it was against a really good team in Metcalf County. Who that player? I don't remember her name.
You'll learn it again because we play them in a Christmas tournament.
Yes, she's really really good. But the summer, I like summer because again, it's even more so that the record means absolutely nothing because you all could lose every game, win every game, and it still doesn't matter what's coming up. What do you learn, though, about your team during those summer games?
Well, you know, I think about we beat Hancock County this summer. You know, we beat Central Hardin this summer, who was really good. Now, we lost some games we probably shouldn't have, but what I liked is we didn't rely on Sydney Perkins for everything. Sutton Van Meter has really picked up her scoring. Arissa has kind of changed her game a little bit where, you know, I tell her all the time I want her to play downhill. She's so strong and she can get to her spots in different ways than a really quick player can. She kind of, you know, she bulls her way in. She dips underneath and gets her shot off. So Arissa had a great summer. Sutton had a great summer. You know, and then our young kids, and I say they're all young, but, you know, Kennedy's coming along and having a good summer. And, you know, in one of the games we beat Hancock, who's a really good team, one of our seventh graders had 14 or 15 points in Bree Jones. So, you know, she's going to really be a help for us this time. But defensively, we're getting better. We're doing some new things. Terminology finally for them is consistent, and they understand what I'm asking, what I want them to do. We don't always do it, obviously, but you know, they understand how we're going to play now. It's at a whole new level compared to you know, what they've been used to. So and I think it's going to be good for us.
Preseason rankings, I think I asked you last year, does it matter? And you, I think, said no. No, the Cats Paws didn't have you all ranked. We're starting this year third region media poll with 13 representatives from around the region to vote. And right now you all, I think, are in 11th or 12th on that, just on the outside. Do you care? Does your team care?
No, and, you know, you have to think we're coming off winning three games, so we're ranked where we should be. And who is it? Dennis Green says we are what our record says we are. And that's exactly where we should be, down toward the bottom. And, you know, these girls have to fight for that. They have to fight for that respect. And, you know, Grayson County, boys or girls, has always been a really respected program. And we've got to get back to that. And, you know, I think we can. I think we will. The best days of this program are still a couple years away. I mean, again, we got two seniors, one junior, sophomores, not very many sophomores, three or four, and then three or four freshmen. The rest are middle school kids, and the middle school kids are really talented. And, you know, it's one of those things that they'll have an opportunity this year, and we got to blend them in with some of our experience. Our older girls are really good with them. I encourage them, bring them out, and, you know, they're practicing with us now. But, you know, being ranked 12th or 13th, I don't know who's below us, but that's appropriate.
You all scrimmage South Warren and Clinton County. I know Clinton County was last weekend. I talked to Elena Jones, Coach Elena Jones. I got to be careful. I can't just say Coach Jones. And I know she said that you all held their best player, who's really talented, to, I think she said, 3-5 points, something
well,
like that.
We did, and she was 3-for-25 from the field. So she got a couple free throws. So maybe she may have had double figures, but the Austin fact that she had to work so hard to get those points, and most of that was Ella Narvez and Kennedy Green and Lucy Torrance. And you know, she's probably 5'10", 5'11", guard that really handles it and can shoot it, but – We saw them this summer, so we were kind of prepared for her. But, you know, we played really well down at Clinton and ended up beating them by, I think, 12, 15, 14. I can't remember. But we were up by 20 in the third quarter, and three girls in double figures, and, you know, from Isabel to Sydney, and the other one, I think, was Arissa. So, you know, we played really well, and Ella has played as good as she's ever played down there. And then, of course, we played South Warren last night, and we didn't play nearly as well, and kind of reverted back. And but the second half was something we could build on against a good team.
Yeah, because that's exactly what I was leading into. Is that I got here, I came in a little bit late. I had another commitment that I had to go to. Got there about halfway through the first quarter, and in the second half, your team was a lot better. and I mean, defensively, they play better, but still, you help South Warren to what, 40 points?
Yeah, and you know, we lose by 14 points and held them to 40. And, you know, we have a tendency to do that. And I still, you hear people talk about us playing slow. We're not playing slow. We'll, if we can rebound, we're pushing it as hard as we can, and we're trying to do some different actions in transition to get quick shots. But, you know, it just didn't happen last night. We couldn't make a shot, couldn't make a layup, and, you know, through our two scrimmages, we have a higher three-point field goal percentage than we do two-point field goal percentage. And so that's been a focus of ours, too, is really trying to focus on making short shots, making eight-foot jumpers, layups, and all of that. And we've been doing better in practice, but we just haven't carried it over, or at least we didn't last night. And I think we shot 25% from the two-point range last night.
Last season, I asked you about youth and said, ooh, River just missed a dunk there. You know, I think he's going to go back
and
try
back there.
Well, you
missed Jack. Jack just hit one down
there.
Did he?
Yeah. I was going to say, I was looking away. He just tried it again. I think missed it one more time. I was going to say, I was looking at you, so I was missing that. And you missed Rivers here, so maybe you have the good luck. But I asked you last season a question about youth and how your team was young. Still young. Still very young. But they are more experienced in having another year of varsity experience. How does that help?
A great deal. And Sutton's a completely different player. From last year as a freshman point guard. And, I mean, she got thrown to the wolves and kind of had to learn on the fly and got so much better throughout the year. But she never really had played with any swagger or any confidence. She was always playing not to make mistakes instead of being aggressive. You know, and this year, you know, she's taken as many, if not more, shots in our two scrimmages than Sydney and is making them. And she's playing well. And like I said, and you got a point guard that can handle it and make good decisions and score all at the same time. It makes her really tough, makes her hard to guard. And, you know, and so really pleased with her and our youth. Isabel hit three threes against Clinton County and played really well. And, you know, her factor is still strength and playing against really strong girls. But Kennedy Green, freshman, Lucy Tarns, freshman, Lexi Logson, freshman, they're all going to play. You know, and our sophomores being Ella and Brooklyn got hurt last night, so she's out for a while. But Sutton, so, you know, we those girls, good thing is, you know, coming in here last year when I introduced new stuff and, you know, they didn't play, so, you know, the terminology was not anything different where, you know, Arissa's played for three coaches in 4 years. So I believe, I could be wrong on that. She may not have been here when Coach Basham was here. But,
no, she was still in Hart County.
Okay, so you know, and that's tough on those girls, but I'm telling you, I'm really looking forward to the year. I'm excited about it. There'll still be some nights where we'll pull some head scratchers, but there's going to be some nights we're going to give everybody all they want, too. And our defense has really improved, and it's something that I think can keep us in games like it did last year. But now we're scoring more, so hopefully we can turn some of those L's into W's.
You got a holiday tournament this year before Christmas at Edmondson County, the Caveland Classic. You've got three teams. What is it? Metcalf, Green, and Paris, I believe, are the three teams that you're playing. But I know you told me, I think it was you or it might have even been Travis that was telling me that you, the main reason why you wanted to play in the Caveland Classic was it was at Edmondson County. River just hit his dunk there. He just got his dunk there.
All right.
That's where the district is.
Yeah,
does that matter?
I think it does. And, you know, our girls have played there some, especially Arissa and them throughout their 4 years here. But, you know, we get three games in a row there over Christmas, and then we're going back in February, you know, a month and a half later to play in the district tournament. So that is, you know, I got some good buddies down there and all of that. So Brad asked us to come, so I told him I would. But, you know, he's easy to say no to compared to what I think or what at least I'm hoping. Playing three extra, or we'll play four, play there four times this year. So, before the district tournament, so I really hope that can help us.
Your schedule this year is easier than it was last year. I know that was by intent.
Yep.
You've got, I mean, the first game of the season's tough against Breckenridge County, but then you have Washington County. I know in that first stretch of time, you've got Bullitt Central, who's a very talented team. University Heights.
Yep.
What do you see from your schedule in the comparison between this year and last year?
Well, you know, the first two games of the year at Breck and at Bullitt Central is probably the two best teams on our schedule. You know, Paducah Tillman, we're playing them. They're coming here. They're going to be good. But I did. I mean, we've got a bunch of 50-50 games this year. You know, and I think our district tournament games are 50-50 games. And, you know, if you can pull some of those out and then win, you know, we play Washington County twice, UHA, we play McLean County twice, of course, Hancock. And, you know, so it's much more conducive to what we need with such a young team. And, again, none of them are givens that we're just going to show up and win. But we've got a bunch of games that are – we have as good a chance to win as the other team, and that didn't happen very often last year. So I think that's going to be good for us.
You touched on the district there very briefly, and it's an interesting district. I think Edmondson County's probably the favorite this year, but I don't think they're quite as big of a favorite as maybe Butler County was a year ago.
No,
and then you look, Whitesville Trinity lost Morris and lost Hibbett. And then Butler County lost a ton, but they still do return two or three players of their scores. This district's interesting, isn't it?
It really is, and you know, it could be similar to the boys last year, where the 4 seed beat the 1 seed, and then 4 seed end up winning the district. And you know, Edmondson, their size is going to cause all of us problems. Two big girls inside, and so their size is a difference maker for them. And you know, Butler's got two starters back, very good, tough, physical, aggressive team. Trinity, they did probably lose the most with Morris and the big big girl inside. And now they got the all-girl back who shoots it as well as anybody in the region. So, you know, and all their girls play volleyball, so you know they're athletic. They all run and jump and had one of the best volleyball teams in the region. So, you know, it's – by no means going to be easy for anybody. And, again, it could be one of those things where everybody beats everybody. So it's going to be a challenge.
When talking with Arissa for our Cougar conversation, I'm not sure if you got a chance to go back and watch that when it happened or not. The word she kept using, communication. You know, what do you need to get better at? Communication. What does communication look like on a basketball court?
Defensively, it's the difference between being good and not good. It really is. And makes me happy that she talks about it all the time. And if somebody comes to our practice, they'll hear me say it. And even on our scrimmages, you got to talk. We got to talk. And we are 100 times better at talking right now than we were last year. But we still got a ways to go because we're still so young, sometimes still shy, and they haven't all come out of their shell yet. But we're better at it. It changes. You know, I tell them all the time, if you want to get yourself mentally into a game, and then talk in warm-ups, communicate, yell at each other, whatever it is. But in a basketball game, you cannot be a good defensive team if you don't talk. There's too many things that happen in transition defense, which was a weakness of ours last year, is a lot better. By no means as good as it needs to be, but 10 times better. And what we do is we're really good right now at rotating one time. You know, we can scramble, and everybody's like, I've got so-and-so, and we get matched up pretty quick, but we were not quite where we need to be when we rotate two or three times, when you got to help the helper, things like that. So it's getting better, and they're starting to understand it, but I'm telling you, if you don't hear us talking during the games, you're going to hear me yelling.
I know coaches always like to say, you know, come February 20th in Brownsville, it doesn't matter if you're 29-0, 0-29, whatever, 14-15, yep. Your record means absolutely nothing. How do you use those? I think it's 29, if I could count right when I counted up the schedule. How do you use those 29 games to make sure your team is playing the best basketball, whether it's Butler, Edmondson, or Whitesville, that you're playing on that Monday in February at Brownsville?
Well, for right now, the one thing that is the easy answer to that is figuring out rotations. Who can come in for who, and we don't miss a beat. Because right now I'm playing 9-10 girls in our two scrimmages. I would like to continue that, and we're getting some of our freshmen getting 6-8 minutes, maybe 10 minutes at a time. But figuring out what are the strengths of our girls, and if I put Ella in, Ella knows that she's got to wreak havoc for us defensively and on the boards. She's athletic, she's fast, she's got to go rebound. You know, Lucy's probably our best offensive post player, so when Lucy Torrance comes in, she's got to look to score. So just kind of fitting the puzzle together and finding out who plays best together and fitting, you know, trying to find some rest for Sydney, Arissa, and Sutton, because they would play 30 to 31, a lot of times 32 minutes a game. And some of that we were able to pull off because we didn't press.
last year. I am wanting to press and do some trapping this year, a little different, because we do have a little bit more depth. Last year we didn't have any depth that could come in and really help us. So this year we've got 9, 10, 11 girls that I feel like I can put in, and we don't really lose a lot. So I was telling Sydney has played 25 minutes at Clinton County and then played 22 minutes last night, and she sat out the last few minutes with a sprained ankle. But, you know, if I can get her still scoring her 15 to 17 in 25 minutes compared to her having to play 32 minutes, it just makes us better and fresher for the end of the year.
Well, November the 29th, I think is what it is, next Tuesday, I guess. It's coming, and it's coming really quick. I know we're really excited for it, and I'm excited to see what this team can bring in this year.
Well, I am too, and I think we're going to surprise a lot of people. Again, Brett County's a tall task, first game of the year, and then followed up with Bullitt Central. But, we're going to compete. We're going to fight, and I hope Brett doesn't beat us by 40 this time. Chad will run it up on me if he can, I know. But hopefully we're better off, and we won't turn it over 30 times like we did last year.
Coach, I appreciate it. We will see you on November the 29th.
Thanks. Appreciate it.
That's head coach Todd Johnston. We'll take a break. Meet the Cougar Night continues in just a moment. This is Meet the Cougar Night on K105.
When caring for a family member, their state of health is continually on your mind. And when they're faced with a health concern, you'll do just about anything to make them feel better. Rest assured, their feel better starts right here at Midway Pharmacy. We take our time to get to know all about your family's health history so we can provide you with educated advice. So when someone's counting on you to help them maintain a healthy lifestyle or to overcome that untimely sickness,
is going to get close to wrapping up our coverage for the 2022-23 Meet the Cougar Night. Again, the season will open up on November the 22nd, or 29th, rather, as they will play at Breckenridge County in a girl-boy doubleheaders. This is Cougar boys JV action right now. There's a shot taken from straight at the top of the key and knocked in. And we'll be with you pretty much all season long. I know we made the schedule. I think it's something like 52 of the 60 potential games we'll be broadcasting between the two teams. And really, when we're not broadcasting, it's only because the other team is playing. And obviously, we cannot be in two places at once. We're not quite that good just yet. Be sure to, if you're watching with us on YouTube, subscribe to the YouTube channel. You will not make sure to not miss any of the action doing that. And you'll also be able to watch all season long on K105's Facebook page, the K105 Sports Twitter, as long as Twitter still continues to be a thing. You never really know with that. And watch, listen to it as well, K105, 103.9 The Moose. You can download the apps as well, as we've got some hockey substitutions here coming in for the JV team as the season continues to get ready to go. Are they going to try a half-court shot at the buzzer? And it is, just off to the left. That would have been one way to end the night. As that'll pretty much wrap up our coverage. What we're going to do here, though, really quickly is just show you one more time the schedules for both these teams. First off, for the Cougar boys, you see you can take a screenshot of it right now, but you can also find this on our social media platforms. You can find that. Take a look at the Lady Cougar schedule. Again, same thing. You can find that on our social media channels. We'll also have them on to K105.com next week. Tomorrow, Cougar basketball team will be hosting scrimmages all day, as they will play against Hart County at 7 o'clock. Be sure to come out and support the team. And then the Cougar boys will be hosting a holiday tournament that will be coming up. In fact, that's your first look at the bracket. I'm not sure that's really been released. There's your little bit of a surprise, as they'll face Glasgow. And then the winner, they will face either Bullitt Central or Nicholas County. It is South Warren, Davis County, Clinton County, and Greene County. Those Clinton County and Greene County were the two that Brett Johnston and I couldn't remember. That'll wrap up our coverage tonight. I want to thank our multitude of K105 Digital Productions crew. We had a full house in helping up some training, so we appreciate you bearing with us as we were dealing with some issues. So that'll wrap up our coverage. I want to thank the crew. So until November the 29th, this is Sam Wormley saying so long, everyone.